I hope you're doing good. I'm glad you were able to make it. I'm just posting the stream link to a couple places, and then I'll be getting started. Oh, great. I'm glad to hear that. If you hear background noise, that is one of my gerbils going crazy on a piece of wood. Oh, okay. Well, that works. All right. I was thinking it would be neat to make this look like a proper litter. Having their parents displayed as well. Yeah. Make it look all official. I do a lot of rotating too. I apologize. All right. Oh, okay. Let's pull up an old background to get some texture. I think this one might look nice. If you're tuning in, I am working on a two-pup litter commission for Sleipn-r. I hope I'm saying your username right. And LeftLefttheGecko. And I'm thinking this will be a lot of fun. We don't get a lot of litter commissions, so getting to explore that is going to be. Gonna be nice. All right. And of course, if there's anything that you see that needs changing or editing, be sure to let me know and we can figure it out and go from there. Or if there's anything that's just not jiving, anything like that. Okay, so I'm going to try and pronounce this. Sleipn-r? I'm not too familiar with the Norse horse name, but I'll have to look it up. So we have Saga and Loriz as the parents. I'm going to save this before I have a computer crash. So I think what I'm going to do, since they're both going to use the same lines, is I'll make the pup lines, and then we'll just edit them from there for each of them, and their specific traits. I think that'll work. Yeah. I think I'm gonna do the pup lines on a different canvas here, just so we have a little more space. Oh, okay. Well, that's nice of you. So both are going to have that long flowy tail. Okay. I think they're gonna make such cute pups, these two put together. Like, it's such a unique combo too, especially like Saga's more subtle colors with Loriz more like bright and bold colors. Like, I think that'll be nice. Hi, Yang. I hope you're doing well. It's not going to be a surprise, but, well, I mean, I guess it will to you all, but they do have, specific traits for each of the pups that they want incorporated. So, and this is going to be two flat colored pups, but they're each different from one another. But they're going to be using the same same baselines, so to speak. And I'm just getting in some posing here first before we go in with fur. Yeah. Yeah, I'm super excited to get to do these. I don't get to do a lot of commissioned litters. I know I do my monthly litters, but that's a little bit different. So it's always a nice change of pace to get to do stuff like this. Okay, now both of them have that long Saga tail. This is going to be fun. Big tail. Actually, I think what I'm going to do is just go over the top of this one first. That's awesome. That they're mates. I love it when people pair up designs I've made like that and they develop them more and stuff. Just seeing where people take them, it's awesome. I think I'm going to make his mouth just a little more tapered, like his parents. Yeah, that has to be fulfilling to see the canon offspring. I'm happy to help bring it to reality. It's a lot of fun. Extremely fulfilling for me. It's like getting well, that makes me feel good. I'm happy to help bring it all to life and see the dreams realized, and just knowing people are interested in these characters and wanting to do more with them and stuff is just makes me happy. Knowing they, you know, bring so much fulfillment to people and enjoyment, that's what matters. Out here making ships sail, huh? Okay, I feel like his front feet are a little bigger, so I'm gonna bring his back feet into perspective. This is the fun part when you get to manipulate their head size and figure out what looks right. Little, there we go. He was needing just a little bit bigger head. Maybe we get a little more. Scruff. I might bring that in just a hair. There we go. Okay, now his head looks a little big. I'm gonna edit the rest of him. There we go. Yeah, like developing their stories and like where they go forward in that, you know, since when you've had them and stuff, like what offspring they have and what they do with their lives. And it's always interesting to see how people take designs and do what they do with them. So some like a good tragic backstory, and others like to role play with them, and some like to just develop a nice happy tale. And I don't know, I think it's a good way for people to be able to, you know, be creative and explore things. And all kinds of potential. Oh, thank you. I'm glad you like the pose so far. I'm thinking he has to have a good way to show off his tail. Well, the pups do anyway. So now we gotta get that long, luxurious tail. Yay! I'm glad. That makes me happy. Okay. So if we're gonna do a nice long tail here. Oh, wrong layer. Thought I had chosen a new layer. I was wondering why. Okay. Me when I'm trying to find layer 15552, copy one. Yeah, and the wings. And I noticed both of them have like relatively shorter ears, so I tried to carry that over in these lines. But if either of you guys want longer ears or shorter ears, just let me know, and I'm happy to change that. Got his foot all covered up. There we go. Oop. Oh, okay, great. I do have a question on the document y'all sent me. Is Pup 2's name, or is that just a placeholder if I include their names on this litter sheet? Okay, that's fine. I just wanted to make sure. I was thinking, like, name is an excellent name. Like, that would be kind of cool. Yes, my name is name. I was like, that's either really nifty or just not filled out yet. Like, now I want to make a cool dog. Named like unnamed or something. I don't know. Just inspired by that. Right. I love little stuff like that. Like when people are creative and a little cheeky. Okay. Oh, the ribbon tail, the long tail. Oh, that's cool. Icelandic for boy. Let's see how this fits on here. Oh, just a leg. Okay. Let me retry that. Whoops. And I also have to make space for wings. Okay. So if we did something like that, that would still give us proper space for some wings. Okay, and his name was Jabez. I hope I'm not mispronouncing anything. If I am, I apologize. Reshef, R-E-S-H-E-P-H, R-E, thank you. I'm glad you like it. I would imagine, you know, being two siblings, they would pair off against one another like this and be like, rah. Looking all cool. Okay. So do both of them have bird feet on all four limbs, I'm assuming? Okay, I will do that. I love bird feet. They're so much fun. Okay, yeah, I can do that. That is no problem. Have a little toe come out here. Maybe some longer toenails. Good old bird feet. I think I'm gonna make this one a little bit. There we go. So if you're tuning in, do you like bird feet or do you like mammalian feet when it comes to your design? I like both. I think they both have some coolness. Yeah, I think bird feet work really well to give it almost a darker, more primal feel, I guess might be the word I'm looking for. Yeah. Do you guys like the feet here? Before I move on. Okay, awesome. No rush. Awesome. All right. So neither of them have quills. And there is a portal on pup one. Okay, so there's 4 wings on pup one and 6 wings on pup two. All right, let me see. Let me see if I can, I can do that. I think I can. I got faith. Get a general layout here where we want to put those wings. All right. So there's one. And two. Probably angle this up a little bit more. So there's one and two. There's one set. A third set we could put right here, and then of course they'll be mimicked for the faraway pair. And just a rough sketch there. Okay. I really like how you guys made the pups destructive and like full of despair. I think that's so cool. That is a good song. I've not heard it in quite a long time. That whole movie is pretty good. And especially the soundtrack. Oh, I'll have to check it out. I love covers of songs. There's a really beautiful cover. I don't remember who did it, but there's a really beautiful cover of O Come, O Come, Emmanuel in Hebrew, and it's like the most beautiful ethereal version of the song I've ever heard. I just love it. Well, we got one wing down. Let's bring some of that up onto the back here. That's awesome that they made it metal. All right, now the wing under here. Okay, so we got two wings. Let's copy those over and then make a third. About right there. Wonder if I can. Just scooch everybody over a smidge. There we go. making this third wing for Jabez. Might taper these ends just a little bit more. To fit in with his other wings. There we go. Will also be the far wings that aren't going to be as detailed, but they're still back there. There we go. I'm gonna save before I lose anything here. Okay. He has a Lunae. both have the Lunae. And there is a portal on Reshef. Okay, so I think I'm ready to add color if you guys like the lines. We can get started on the flat color process. Awesome. All right, I'll get started on some color then. Now, in your guys' description, where it says having base coloring fading to Loriz's colors, do you want like most of it to be like Saga and then elements of Loriz, or do you want it to like start at the head and end with Loriz colors in the tail, or like it? I just want to make sure I'm understanding y'all correctly. And I will start getting a base layer set down. I'm just going to use the standard blue that I'll manipulate later. Okay, yeah, we can do that with a Reshef. Okay, that's fine. And for the Lunae, do you guys want the exact same colors as Loriz, or do you want like just the same style slash element? And we can try different colors. Yeah, okay, we can do that. If we need to, we can also change this background color if we feel it's contrasting too much with the design, or if it's not bright enough or something. So that's totally doable too. I was hoping though this gray would make the subtle hues of Saga's colors really pop a lot better. But we can see. We can wait and see. Yeah, that sounds good. With Jabez Lunae. The long tail. I also really like that neither of them have quills. I think that is really cool. And it goes along like with their tale of not being accepted by society and stuff. Because in the Aquili world, quills are something of a status symbol. Yeah. That too would have been crowded. Especially when we start involving portals. Trying to do a portal inside all the quills and stuff. It's just like, it's a little tight space here, guys. I wonder if I'll be able to flip this around. Let's see. And use it for Jabez. I gotta get it just perfect though. Oh. It's not too far off. There we go. And go for it. I wouldn't say it's a hard and fast rule within my my realm, but in general, quills are a status symbol. But there are some quill-less beasts that also have much power and regard. All right. Yeah, that's a cool idea. Kind of insinuating, you know, the disparity there. I'd have to do the math. I'd have to sit down and look at it. When I eventually put these guys up and do their description, I'll look at the math. But yeah, they're good chunk quill. So all right, so if we're gonna do Rishev, paste, let's focus on that. So I would imagine that brownish color fading into a darker color. I also think I'm gonna take these lines. They're slightly blue, so I'm gonna blacken them up. There we go. And And then this tail will have fade to the bluish, purplish, maroony colors of Loriz. Yeah. Yep. I get you. Now I gotta blend. Okay. So I think if we go with the purpley maroon color first, that works really well with the brown. Yeah. And then that blue teal color. Then we'll get that brighter. It's kind of coming out more pinky than I want. Let's see if we can make it. There we go. A little more red toned. Still getting some of those same blue hues. There we go. We can make that red a little bit more subtle if we want. Yeah, we can do that. That's no problem. We can bring it up to here if we want. We can even bring it up onto the wings. We can make it a little darker if we don't want such a pink hue. Yeah, the tips of the feet, we can do that. That's no problem. And I'll just blur this out. It kind of looks like she's been, or this character has been doing like death and destruction work on the side with their stained red tootsies. Yeah, it's no problem. Now let's add some more elements to work with here. Let's do the portal and see how it looks. And blend this out. Oh, okay, yeah. He's the darker of the two. That makes sense. And because this is flat colored, it's going to have a little bit different look than the fully shaded portal. But I think we're still able to manage some nice colors here. Maybe there's some little sparkly bits coming from this other dimension. Who knows? Okay. And then the Lunae. Let's try that. I'm thinking maybe if Reshef's Lunae matches the colors of the portal, which we can totally change these colors if they don't work, if they're too bright. It's just a thought though. That might be something to consider here. So I think if we want to get the full effect of the Lunae, I'm just going to build it right on top of our lines here. if I can draw a straight line. That's the hard part. And a little highlight on his scales. Okay. Oh, okay. Thank you for relaying that. Around the face and chest area. Okay. And they want a little more of the maroony purple. We can do that. Yeah. I like how Reshef is kind of going from like the head and upper body of Saga to Loris's tail, and then it'll be opposite on Jabez, with the head being the face and chest being Loris's darker blue, and then Saga's towards the tail. I think that'll be cool. Little opposite action. So more of the blue towards the head and face. More like this color. Yeah, we can test it out and see if you like it. Or even do like a mixture of the two if you want. Oh no, I'm getting memory warnings. let me save my file real quick. Just make sure we're okay. Don't you hate it when you're drawing and like an ad pops up in your corner that's like your antivirus? Like, no, I just want to draw. Here we can get some of that brown. Now we can get some dark color of Saga. Oh, thank you, Mint Poppy. Yeah, we can try a mixture. Yeah, I love the bird feet too. They're fun. I think we want to add a little bit more brightness to this blue. Not all over, but just enough. If we want to, we can bring in just a little bit of that maroon on Jabez. And we can also make it subtle. So maybe something like that, and then we can blur that out. I'm loving how their colors are combined. Okay, so let's test out that maroon. Yeah. Let's see how it would look more red toned here. There we go. That's oops, wrong layer. Don't you hate when you touch the wrong layer? Okay. Ooh, that's cool. I think that's pretty cool. So that is what it would look like, kind of maroon colored. We could take it darker like that, or just leave it with the red. And then awesome. I'm liking the reds too. I think they look very nice. I'm thinking maybe, let's see if we can change the portal color instead of this purpley. What if we did, because they are like a dark entity, what if we did like a darker portal like that? I think that could be cool. But it's totally up to you. We can always change it back or change it to something different. And then I'm also thinking, what if me try something here. I think the black looks better than the pink, personally, just because it draws into that darkness. Yeah. And I wonder almost if we did like a eclipse effect here with the lunae. Just a thought. We can always change it back. What if we still want to retain the color. What if we just brought in some darker hues here? Maybe something like that. Awesome. Now I wonder if we can bring this into a more brighter red instead of a pink. Let's see how that will like really give it almost like a blood moon, despair, destruction, fire in the streets type feel. Yeah, there we go. I kind of like how Res Chef is almost embracing more of the warm tones, and Jabez is going to be embracing more of those cooler tones and blues. I think that'll be really nice. Awesome. I'm glad you love it. Okay, so let's see here. I don't know. Okay. Yeah, I can make the face darker. That is no problem. If I can find my layer. I'm on the hunt for the right layer. There it is. Okay. Okay, so from the back, maybe like right there, one of these darker hues. We'll blend this color out on the face here. Ooh, I like that color. That's a pretty color. I'm a big fan for dark blues. So they both have blue-toned eyes, with Loriz being a little bit more bright. Oh, awesome. I like the darker face too. I think it suits Jabez better. So maybe, what if Wrist Chef, whoops, if I can stay in the lines, maybe okay. I can change it to brown or whatever works. The brown on the back right foot. Okay. And that can be done. And we can blend this brown up into the blue if you like, or we can make it stop abruptly. just a little bit of a highlight to the scales. Really catching that light. Okay. Like how it is now, where it's more abrupt. Awesome. All right. So do you guys like these base colors so far? And eye color? If so, I'll start working on some details inspired by the parents. Awesome. Okay, yeah. We can make them darker. How about something like that? Just a tad darker. I can make this leg a little darker too. Awesome. So here's where we're at so far. I'm going to go ahead and merge some layers so I can save properly. If you guys like these base details, I'll get started with some design on their bodies. And were you both wanting decor on them? We could totally do that if you want decor. One of my first thoughts too is I think this light coming off the portal would put a little bit of a highlight on some of these feathers. So I was wanting to include that. Something like that. Especially these ones right near it. Maybe as they get away from the portal, they fade a little bit. Something like that. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, we can do just minimal, simple decor on both of them then. If they get any. Oh, thank you. I'm glad you like it. And maybe a little bit of a highlight up here off of their lunae. So Recif would be this little red. Then they'll do a bit of a blue on Jabez. Something like that. Yeah, that's fine. We can do that. I'm thinking about just adding elements of their parents on each of their designs in different ways. And we can go from there. I kind of want to bring in more of these blue elements on the tail, but I also don't want to make them clash too much. So what if maybe you had this, some of these bluer gray tones that are also found on Saga. It almost has a greeny element to it, which I think is pretty. Maybe some of this color gets found in the tail here too. Circle that could mimic the lunae. The interior of the ear. What if we did that as well? And blurred it out. And then this diamond shape, we could, if we want to, bring on to the wing. Maybe with each descending feather, it gets a little bit less. Something like that. And something I really like is this white stippling on the wing. But I'm thinking, what if instead of white, what if we brought in some of this red? So you get some of this red stippling up here. Just a thought. Thank you. If there's anything that you don't like or anything, you just let me know and we can always try something new. I wonder if we can bring any of this white. Oh, we could do those rib lines. That could be fun. Let's see. Oops, wrong color. Where is it picking up red? Oh, okay, I see. Oh, I'm glad you do. Then we can kind of fade those out. And there's more lines on Loriz and his funky little tail end. And he has more sparkles. Oh, yeah, and there's also that circle mark. We could always work with that. Do a nice big circle. Let's see. There's a dot in the middle. We could even double it up if we wanted. This could also feed into these line designs here. Look like they're kind of coming off. All right. And there would also be a little bit of a highlight there on the rump where that color's coming in. Blur that out. Maybe he could paint himself if he wanted with war paint, going against the world that dislikes him. If we wanted to bring in something more significant, that's an option there. Or we can tone it down like that. Okay, yeah, we can make that circle smaller. And these can be right there on the chest. Let me fix that elbow real quick. Make this a little more subtle. There we go. Oh, sorry about that. I grabbed everything. Let me make them a little bit bigger. There we go. Maybe something like that, a little bit smaller. And if we wanted to, we could mimic that circle on the thigh, give that same sort of energy. Yeah, we can add splashes of red. I also like that it has this almost like war paint feel to it. Like he is dressed and ready to bring hell to wherever he's at. Something like that, maybe. We could even put a little under his eye here. And we could also mimic some of this line work around the cheek and neck on Saga. We could do with red here on this pup. Yeah, boy, looks like he was destined to go down the dark path. He was made for it. So something like this, maybe? Where he's got some of those red accents. Ooh, I like him. Oh, he's looking cool. We could also add a little bit of red to the tail. Like a streak of blood, but brighter. Maybe it kind of fades when it gets to this blue. There. Awesome, awesome. I'm glad you are. We could even add a little bit of red highlight to the wing. So maybe in the middle of each of these little markings here. That also could draw the eye to that dark area of the wing. And because it's so small, we can leave it pretty opaque. and get away with it. Yeah, we can do that. Extend that red into the blue. Make it really pop, almost like veins and arteries. Something like that. So here's how he's looking so far. Oops. A little further into the blue. Okay, I can do it. What about like this? Ooh, I like that mix. That's cool. Awesome. That really makes them pop. Mm-hmm, I agree. Are there any other markings you'd like to see on him? Awesome. What were you thinking decor wise? Do you want him to have a little bit of decor? Or would you just like to leave him how he is? The only thing I can think of is maybe like a little bit of red decor. Or if you wanted a little bit of blue decor, we could do that too. Yeah, I'm partial to the red as well. Great minds think alike, they say. Okay, so let's see here. Just a little bit of red. Okay, that's a little bright. Let's tone it down just a bit. What if he had a little leg bands? Maybe an ear dangly. Something like that. Just enough to set him apart. We could extend one down here on this wing too. I think it looks so cool. Yeah, that's what I was worried about. We could just remove it. This piece hanging down here. That's an option. Or we could change the color. We could like brighten it. Make it a deeper red. just for contrast, here's what it would look like blue or gray if you wanted to do that route. And if you wanted, like if we did this, we could always add some red beads. That's an option, so we can still bring in some of that red. You prefer the red to the blue? Okay, that's fine. That's no problem. Ooh, blue beads on red. That's a good idea. We could even gray them out to kind of match his markings if we wanted to. Or we could tap into that blue on the tail. A little more blue like that. Oh, yeah, that to me, that helps set apart the lines from the portal a lot better by adding those beads. Blue like the tail. Okay, let's see how those look then. Bring this up to color. So it'd be about like that. Me too, I do too. I think it really helps set it apart, and it also helps draw that blue up into the design without making the rest of the design blue. You know what I mean? I think it really works. Awesome. Well, I'll get started on Jabez then and see what we can do. Did Left have any specifics when it came to the actual patterns on the design? If not, I'll just start experimenting. Okay, yeah, we can bring some of that maroon back into the where the blue is. That's no problem. All right, so what if we brought more maroon into the body? And then the head, we could leave that dark blue and kind of work our way up into it with this color. Maybe something like that. And if we want to, we can still bring some of that blue in onto the stomach here, just to give it a little more and blur that out. Something like that, maybe. Maybe. A little bit darker right here to give some definition, some depth. Okay, well, how is this strip of blue on the belly? Is this, I'll define it a little more here. Wait, it kind of connects up to her head and chest there. Awesome. Awesome, awesome. Yeah, I think that looks a lot more cohesive. Were there any specific design elements or pattern elements left wanted from either of the parents? If not, I'll start designing. Okay, yeah, we can do that. The diamond from Saga's face. Yes, I like that. Let's see what we can do here. We got the diamonds on the forehead. We got some more diamonds. I love the little diamonds underneath. We could kind of drag that up onto the neck here, these color hues. We could also bring those diamonds from the back onto Jabez's body if we wanted. So just a concept. We can always change. So maybe we could add some shoulder diamonds. Oop. They could lend themselves to lines. And of course, we could always work these lines into a red. And then just blend them out like that. And on Loriz's back, there's some lines that we could work in if we wanted. Or these fun riggedy lines on the tail. So maybe there's lines down here we can work with. Okay, yeah, we can change that. If we want to embrace the blue, that is an option. I actually really like that blue against the maroon. I think it's pretty. We could bring some of that diamond shape up onto these feathers. Kind of mimicking what Reshef has going on, but a little bit different. If we start it here at the base of the wing instead of the exterior. Yeah, me too. Awesome. Yeah, this is just a concept. Bringing in a little bit of that line work on Loriz. Yay, thank you, Mint Poppy. We could even add a little bit of a diamond here in the crook of her elbow. I'm loving her colors. I think they're both really cool. Embracing blue and red. Some of the gold. Okay. Yeah. Like this lighter brown tone. Is that what she means by the gold on Saga? Oh, both are, okay, sorry. I'm not sure on on gender there. So if we want to embrace some of that more light toned goldish brown, we could work it into the wings. I can make this a little more subtle too. There we go. And up here. Blur this out just a little bit. Maybe something like that. Oh, okay. The jewelry and sparkly bits. Yeah, we can work gold jewelry onto Jabez. I can remove the light brown if she wants. That's totally fine. Okay, I get you. Sorry about that. That was my mistake. So some gold jewelry. That's fine. And we can do some sparkles too. I like how they're both so unique from each other, but still siblings. Mm-hmm. They both got their own different ways, but they're still related. If you wanted to, we could do some minimal gold lines. Something like that. Oh, okay. Yeah, we can do that. I can remove mostly off everything but the tail. Maybe something like that. I really like that gold mixed with the blue and maroon. I think that's a pretty combo. We can do it if you want. Okay, do you want it just as decor? Like we could add maybe a gold link here. Ooh, that really brightens up his red too. I like that. And maybe some little gold danglies to go along with the blue. Maybe something like that. Just a little bit. Maybe some gold baubles around his legs. A little bit of gold sparkles. Do you want it just on the tail as well? End of tail and wings. I can do it. So just a little. Just a couple little cute sparkles. I love it. They really set off the colors, I think. Just a couple on the tail here. There we go. That's what we're looking like. Yeah. And the sparkles all have a toggle. I'll have them with the jewelry files, and then they won't be on the jewelry list, so you can see all the markings underneath. Awesome. Is there anything else you guys would like added or changed to these designs? awesome. Well, I'm glad. I will go ahead and make files for you guys, and I'll link it to the group chat we have going on Discord, if you guys are okay with that. It was a lot of fun getting to bring these two to life, and I really like their backstories and their character. Yeah, sure. Awesome. All right, well, thank you guys so much for commissioning me, and I'm gonna cut the stream here as well. So thank you to everybody that come out and watched. It says we have 7 people, so to you 7 people, thank you. And I'll check you tomorrow. So, all right, take care, everybody.